The Prime Minister of St. Lucia says he is very unhappy with the rates charged by Lucelec and has told the management of the electric utility that something has to give. As far as Dr. Kenny Anthony is concerned, Lucelec's electricity rates, whatever the logic may be, are unacceptably high.
And Lucelec has to understand that when there are good times, it enjoys the good times. When there are bad times, it too must make adjustments for the sake of the people of the country. So it's an issue I have raised with them. It is well known that I have said that Lucelec cannot enjoy any longer statutory comfort for specific profit levels. This is not the era for that kind of statutory arrangement.
Dr. Anthony says, as a result, his administration will be moving to amend the legislation that was enacted by the former United Workers' Party administration to afford the company a level of protection. In addition to being the sole provider of electricity in St. Lucia, Lucelec, by reason of the Electricity Supply Act No. 10 of 1994, is guaranteed a return on its investment through a fuel surcharge. Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony, who just recently announced plans to access oil under Venezuela's Petrocaribe initiative, says moving to amend the existing legislation governing Lucelec's operations will be just one aspect of the government's intervention to bring about change in the current electricity rates.
But at the same time, too, we would want to explore with Lucelec alternative sources of energy. Of course, the kind of fuel you get from Venezuela does pose some challenges, because often the turbines that are used to produce electricity may require specific kinds of fuel, and one would have to make an adjustment to determine whether, if we import the fuel from Venezuela, adjustments would be required by Lucelec. But given the larger picture and given what is likely to happen to the Hess oil terminal, it is vital that we ensure that we pursue our strategic objectives, and in all of this, we have to work together.
The Prime Minister says St. Lucia, which has signed the Petrocaribe agreement with Venezuela, hopes to begin reaping the benefits of the initiative by the end of March this year. For the DBS News World, Pete Ninval reporting.